I want to take a closer look at lines and connectors because they look so similar, but there are some differences between the two. I'm going up into Tools, Options, and noticing that I have my Snap to Grid checked, Visible Grid checked. My grid is set at 1 inch by 1 inch with horizontal and vertical subdivisions of 2 and a snap range of 15 pixels. When I refer to the lines and arrows, I mean the arrows toolbar that LibreOffice calls it. And here we have line and line that ends with arrow. These are the same that are on our drawing toolbar down here on the left. The connectors is a different toolbar altogether, but they look very similar. I'm going to add this line that ends with arrow to the grid. First thing we notice is that it snaps to the grid. I'll do the same with the connector that ends with an arrow. And we see that this one does not snap to grid. I'm going to add another line that ends with an arrow. And if I hold down Shift and move my cursor, we'll see that our line is now constrained to 45 degrees and also the snap points. When I try that with a connector and I hold down Shift, nothing happens. Now going back to the line here, if I hold down this 45 degree line, it will go 45 degrees unless I hold down Shift, then it will do the opposite and let me spin it freely. I'm going to add another line that ends with arrow, and this time I'm going to hold down Alt, and we'll see the line will grow from the center. It will also snap to grid. It snaps to grid that center point because it snapped before it recognizes the Alt. Now that I have Alt, it will not snap to grid because Alt does the opposite with snap to grid. Let's try that again with our snap to grid turned off. I grab my line. I'm going to come up here by this center point, but not right on it. Hold down Alt, and we see that it still grows from the center, but it's not snapping to the grid in the center, but where I have my cursor, it snaps to the grid. My left side does not need to snap to grid because it can't do both. So it snaps the side where my arrow is at, or crosshairs in this case. And when I add a connector and I hold down Alt, we see that it's no different than just adding an arrow. Now I'm going to add that same arrow. And let's change that line thickness, make it a little thicker. And we will change the color, make it red. We can also change the arrow on the end. Make it a small arrow. Let's try that now with a connector. We add our connector. Let's change the width of that arrow. Make it a little thicker. Change the color. Change the arrowhead. So that works the same whether we've got an arrow or a connector. I've added a new slide, and on here I will add a triangle and a circle. I'm going to add a line that ends with an arrow to attach the two shapes. We see blue squares attaching the two shapes. If I move one of the shapes, the line does not stay attached unless I group them. Now, as long as I'm over a filled shape and get that four-sided arrow, I can move all my shapes. Clicking on it a second time while I have that four-sided arrow, I go into rotation mode, and I can rotate all three objects. I'm going to add the same things on the connector side. And grab a connector. And right away, we see a difference. We see red circles instead of blue squares attaching our connector to our shapes. And if I move one of the shapes, the connector stays attached. If I select all three shapes and try and click a second time to go into rotation mode, it doesn't work. The group itself works and I can move it around as a group, but I cannot put all three shapes into rotation mode. If I select only my triangle and my circle, I can still move this as a group. And if I click a second time, now I go into rotation mode. So when we're including a connector in multiple selected shapes, we don't want to select that connector. Just select the shapes that are connected to the connector, and the connector will move freely between the two. I want to add some text to my line on the left. So I'm selecting it just like I did with my shapes, and I'll start typing in the text. The text is showing up way over here on the right, which doesn't seem to make any sense. But if our line went from left to right, it would make sense because it would be right in the center of where our line would be. And it would be up and down for us to read it easily. Now, when I click off my line, the text gets moved down into the center of the line. And since it's a little difficult to read, I'm going to double click on my text to get back into text mode and hit enter. Now, when I click off that line, we see that it's just above the line that we're looking at. I'll also point out, when I double click and go into text mode, we also have our text formatting toolbar up at the top that we can choose our font color, our font style, left justify, right justify. So those are all available to us when we're in text edit mode. Now I'm going to add some text to my connector. I'm selecting it just like I did my line. And when we're in text edit mode, we also have our text editing tools. And when I click off to get out of text edit mode, our text is still right side up for reading. If I move my shape in the bottom here, we see that the text doesn't change directions. It's always up and down and easy for us to read. On our line, if I move my shape, we have to then come back and move our line, but the text rotates with the line. Now, before I forget, I want to mention that we had a comment in video number 3, the simple flowchart from Blue Gum Tech. He was mentioning that if we click on the line and go into text edit mode, if we right click on this, and this has all the same things that we have up here on our text editing toolbar, but it also has another thing. It has this text option. If I click that, we can put in some text animation, which we've seen in other videos, but also we can go into text, and we've got this text anchor where we can make it in the upper left-hand corner. And I'll click, and here it seems to be a little bit of a bug, but this is our OK. I'm going to click that, and we see that it's upper left-hand corner, and the lower right-hand corner will be at our ending connector. So if I right-click again, go into text, go into the lower right-hand corner. So it has a little box here from the ending position to the starting position. This is our left hand top corner. This is our lower hand right corner. If I say the lower left corner, it will start right here. So there is another option there. If we right click and go into our text option, and I'm going to move this back to the center. And we also have this option on our line. If we double click that, right click now, text. And I can move it to the upper left-hand corner. And I have to click off that object to see the effect. And we see that it's in the upper left. And our lower right will be the end, so I'll just move this back to the center. Yeah.